Many organizations face a lot of issues throughout the value chain in converting a raw material into a product or customer requirements into a product or service. And many organizations, what they can rightfully earn profit, they lose money. And especially in the service industry, the profit leakage areas are not well defined and also very well hidden in the organization. Unlike in a manufacturing where you can very well see the moment you walk into a factory, you can see a lot of inventories. It can be raw material or it can be finished goods or it can be semi-finished goods and so on and so forth. And there are other areas also profit leakage. So what I'm going to talk about in a typical value chain of a manufacturing or a service, what are the opportunity exist? And these are the profit leakage areas, I would call. And definitely if an organization focuses on these areas, and definitely it can improve a lot. Let's look at it. Simple value chain I just wanted to depict just to show the context here. Just look at it. The stage one is the customer acquisition. Stage two is the design of a product or service. Stage three is raw material and other outsourced to procure all those requirement to convert a design into a product, and finally you execute, manufacture, deliver and dispatch in case of manufacturing. A simple value chain. Why I depicted here, you will find every place there are a lot of areas of opportunity which I am going to share with you. Just look at this scenario, either manufacturing or service scenario, it doesn't make any difference. What I'm trying to picturize here, and you send material, manpower, labor and resource in the case of service industry, utilities, technology, system, all these inputs are going into the value chain to convert a raw material into a product or to convert an information into a service to the customer. So what an organization can rightfully earn here, I'm just depicting here, you can earn, let's say, 30% of profit. At the end of the value chain, you earn only a smallest portion of the profit. Let's say instead of 20%, you earn only 8% of the profit, because in the conversion process, there are a lot of places where profit leakage happens. Those are all the areas of improvement opportunity. What an organization can rightfully earn, actual realization, it doesn't reflect the potential profit what they are supposed to earn. I just wanted to drive home the point with this example. There are many areas of profit leakage. This is one such example, obsolete stock, stock-related issues. To put it simple, so why ad hoc assessment, quality issues, inadequate material planning, poor forecasting, item code issues. I have seen many organizations where same type of an item stored in two different item codes because people, there's no standardization of item codes development. So with that result, everybody stores in different item codes. With that result, when we search, it's not available because I search it in a particular way. With that result, the stock exists, but I still order. That's the whole challenge. Warehouse issues, stock obsolete, and project delays and change in specifications and so on and so forth. There are many reasons. This is a profit leakage, but you can see these are the hidden areas where your profit is eaten away. You expect 20% return, whereas you get it at the end of the project only 9 or 8 or 7% for example. So why? So this could be one of the reasons. And typically it affects the cash to cash cycle because an organization is need to generate cash. See, typically any manufacturing organization, the moment you purchase the raw material received, within 30 days or 60 days you are supposed to pay to the supplier. Obviously he will get the money, but my conversion process still going on and on. With the example what I just quoted in my previous slide, poor material planning, change in specifications, design issues and so on will increase the conversion time from raw material to finished goods. With that result, you delay the collection because you delay the project, you delay the delivery, you delay the invoicing, and so is in the case of collection. So the company is starving for money. That's what I'm trying to depict. Supplier has got the payment and conversion process still going on, and then suddenly you and finally you get the cash from the customer after so many days, so many weeks. It depends on the organization to organization. Typically, if you investigate cash to cash cycle, you will find enormous amount of improvement opportunity, and you can directly link it to the profit leakage. So I just wanted to bring in a value chain perspective on the profit leakage. Cash to cash cycle, yes, that starts from more of a technical definition where supplier gets the money and then you get the money from the customer. This I'm depicting the value chain. If you look at this value chain, simple, straightforward, generic, customer requirement, sales and marketing, design of a product or service, and planning, material planning, production planning, supply chain management, getting the material, execution and warehouse, it goes to the finished goods and dispatch is ready and dispatch is done and invoicing is done and collection is done. And this is an upstream value chain and this is a downstream value chain. And finally, to get the customer satisfaction as well as money from the customer. Any organization is interested to generate cash, simple. And how effectively I generate cash is the challenge. But this is a simple value chain. It's not so simple for many organizations because of many areas of weaknesses. For example, pricing is a weakness, design defects is a weakness, resource, the productivity and so on is a weakness, and poor planning of material, poor planning of production is a weakness. Inventory management is an opportunity for profit leakage. Dispatch, if you don't dispatch on time, everything is done, and because of dispatch delay, customer anyway is not going to pay unless you deliver him, and also credit period starts for him. And the delivery is done, delivery delays and quality issues of final, then the customer responds back and saying that it is not as per their requirement, etc. Again, another cycle of profit leakage or rework for that matter. And some more uncontrolled overtime, because many times people feel that, you know, there are a lot of overtime. Overtime in itself, if you investigate, you will find a lot of weaknesses inside the system. I don't say that, you know, overtime should be completely eliminated, but the whole point is overtime, is it acceptable limit? Is it justified enough? Is it supporting the productivity and generating the cash and delivering value to the customer? If not, then overtime in itself is a profit leakage. And finally, expensive mode of bringing raw material. I've seen many organizations, because of the poor planning, they don't get the material on time. With that result, the production guys hurrying it, that they say, no, I need the material right away. Then what they do, then instead of getting it by road, which is cheapest, and they get it from airlifted, and that you lose the money. So with that result, a lot of places the money is getting down the drain, which is not noticed. That's not the traditional way of measuring the KPI. So these are the some of the areas, if you investigate, you will find in an organization n number of improvement opportunity exists. That's why I picked up value chain perspective, and this I picked up from the quality Juran's book, in fact. So very well depicted here. If you look at anything in an organization, you do good, bad, ugly, it's going to affect the organization in a positive or negative way. And a negative means it's going to impact the company in terms of money. So we need to bring in the money conscious. We need to bring in the value conscious to everyone in terms of process. And if you do something here, you waste time here, it's going to cost the company. So if you don't bring in that kind of a sensitization, as well as articulating what the profit leakage, and not only articulate, unless you work on that as a project, it's not going to benefit the company. So this example, I really liked it from the book. I picked it up. So if you see the key cost of poor quality element is the dollar impact is given penalty. Penalty is the high level why, or high level the impact. What are the cost drivers? Partial shipments, incorrect shipments, late shipments. And if you see partial shipments itself, root cause is having poor raw materials, poor workmanship and confusing documents, which means whenever we do root cause analysis, it's not a theory. Every root cause is impacting the company in terms of money value. If you bring in that, ultimately the financial impact of those root causes, it's nothing but what? It's a profit leakage. So unless the value chain just flows without any interruption, without any bottleneck, and every bottleneck, interruption, hindrance is costing the company. That's the sensitization we need to bring in. So here, okay, now I talked about improvement opportunity. When you find an improvement opportunity, how to look at it? Project or process focus. Let's look at this. If you look at this angle is the process, and this angle is the result. And between process and result, what kind of an insight this is getting, the message is getting conveyed. Let's look at it here. If you look at bad, the process is bad and the result is bad. Okay, good. So let's work on. That's a clear case. And the process is bad, but the result is good. This is a problem, because which means you get a result, but the process is not good. That means you need to investigate, because this kind of an organization cannot sustain, because it may give the benefit to the organization at the short term, but not the long term. You can't mature as an organization if your process is not good, but the result is good for some other reason. That's not because of the company. And the process is good, but the result is not good. This is a very interesting fact. The process is good, very well defined. People know how to apply steps. Steps are designed, and probably you must have optimized it, and so on and so forth. But the result is not coming through. The reason could be many times, you know, we design a process according to our understanding. If the result is not good, it's an important indication that there are certain X factors are still missing. What is that? The process is missing to address it. This is an important learning. The improvement opportunity exists here. When the process is good, result is good. This is the stage we need to reach. That means X and Y relationship is very, very important. If the X and Y relationship is not there, good process, no result, and bad process, good result, not good. So the company cannot go to the next stage, and profit leakage cannot be arrested. That's my whole point. That means whenever you need to select project, this quadrant can help you to identify the areas where you need to select projects and link it to the profit leakage. And finally, okay, all this said and done, okay, we know the value chain, we know the profit leakage and the process improvement. Now, as far as the profit leakage is concerned, and according to me, it's not the ownership is only lies with CEO alone or the heads of departments. The whole idea of showing this organogram or the chart here is everybody is responsible in their own place. So I may be responsible for 10% of it. Somebody may be responsible for 20%, but everyone is responsible in the organization. That kind of an organization is important to sensitize, and then only people will buy in and then do improvement projects, and it will benefit the organization. Ultimately, it will benefit the employees as well as the customer. But it has to be drilled down to the level of employee where everybody focusing on the profit leakage to arrest preventing it. That's my suggestion. Takeaway. So we have looked at many slides, and I have just talked about it at length about the value chain, profit leakage and so on. What are the takeaways? Profit leakage is a value chain issue. It is not an isolated process issue or functional issue. That needs to be realized. Fixing profit leakage is everybody's job. The responsibility is not with only one department or CEO or COO. And improvement happens by doing projects. You can't just go randomly doing improvements. You need to select projects. Project pipeline should be there and keep doing it. It need not be, you know, BELT project or Six Sigma or Lean. I'm not recommending anything at this point here, but it has to be a project-based approach. Project-based approach will deliver results. That's what my recommendation. Focus on cash-to-cash cycle. Why I said cash-to-cash cycle? This is an important sensitization of an organization to bring in cash-to-cash. Money goes out. I need to collect money. More and more and more delay, which means the company is starving for money, which means that's an important indicator for everybody to understand. If it takes 120 days to get the cash back from the customer, from the cash goes out to the supplier, why not 100 days? Why not 80 days? That's a question we need to ask. This sensitizes the people and brings in a lot of improvement. Established process and result linkage is very important. There are organizations where they claim that everything is good, but when you look at, there's no process. That's why the quadrant which I explained, the process good, result not good. Result good, process is not good. That's not right. X and Y relationship. X should impact the Y. That's how we need to establish. That's all from me. If you like this concept, cost of poor quality, profit leakage, please do comment and share your experience. I will keep my channel Leaning Towards Six Sigma, and my next blog is on transformation. Thank you so much for patiently hearing. Thank you so much.